Hey guys, welcome to the Linux channel. Usually I take video episodes in front of my whiteboard and I teach various concepts, and especially on Linux kernel programming, networking and stuff like that. Whereas I just thought let me just shoot whatever I'm going to do today in my desk so that it will be kind of interesting to watch. And the objective of this video is almost I need to shoot like a vlog, and this is going to be my first vlog. And and what I need to do is I got a 1 TB 1 TB HP laptop hard drive in this. It's a Toshiba hard disk. I need to use this hard disk, and I need to replace one of my disks inside my NETGEAR ReadyNAS RN104 device. Let me just show it across to the camera. You can see hopefully over here. So this I purchased a while ago, and I keep some of the backups in the NAS drive. And I got a 500 GB 3.5 inch drive which I need to replace with this hard disk. And and what I did is I have almost taken all the backups, and another objective of today's video is I need to use one of my small SSD drives in this prototype device. This I purchased quite a long ago, and this is my TraffiSqueezer project's prototype device. It came along with a small 32 GB SATA mSATA drive. It's a small, very small drive, and there is a provision in this laptop so that I can install this drive. So that becomes primarily its main hard disk. And till I install Ubuntu and everything, and I make my laptop ready, what I'm going to do is I'm going to also replace the drive which is inside the laptop with another drive, which is my 128 GB Transcend drive. And this is my primary drive in which I do all this video editing and everything, and it is amazingly fast. And this again I purchased quite a while ago for my one of my test systems. Let me just show the system also. You can see here, yeah, this is my test PC. Hopefully you can see here. So it contains you know, this drive. And time being I may not use my PC, so in that case actually it is not even my PC, it is a test PC which one of my clients gave, and I may need to send to him at any point of time. So it came along with that PC when I purchased. I got this drive. So what I'm going to do is I need to also replace this 1 TB drive with this, along with this mSATA 32 GB SSD drive. So this is what is the entire thing. I thought let me do a video shoot just in case if you are also playing around with your NAS, it may be quite interesting to watch. And for your information, what I'm going to do is I'm going to shoot the existing drives inside my NAS system. So just before the upgrade and just after the upgrade. So even before I do the upgrade, what I do is after I replace this laptop's hard disk, I'm going to capture the video in the screen, and I'm going to show the hard drive status inside my NAS drive. And I got a 500 GB, and then followed by which a 1 TB and a 2 TB and a 3 TB drives inside it. So I just need to replace a 500 GB drive, and I feel it's high time to replace its 500 GB drive. Down the lane sometime I may need to buy another 6 drive or 4 drive NAS server, something like NETGEAR RN304 or 306 is one of my favorite candidate I'm just considering about us. So I may buy it sometime, and if I buy, maybe perhaps I can still use this 500 GB drive inside that. As long as I'm not a person who turns on the NAS systems all the time. So usually people may get confused. They think it is something, there are certain criteria, they tell certain kinds of hard disk is quite risky to install and stuff like that. It is quite risky to install if you turn your NAS almost like 24/7 and you use it almost like a substitute of your Google Drive, you know, which is existing in your local premises, which is exactly is the case of using a NAS drive. But what is the thing is, it again depends. You can just turn off once your work is over, and you can just turn it on. In that way, it will reduce the drive's wear and tear. And I'm more bothered about reliability at every instance. So this is what is all about. So let us just get back, guys. What I've done is, I have also taken this hard disk enclosure, and what I need this is for once I remove this drive from this laptop, I need to fit inside this enclosure, and I have to remove all the partitions. And I mean, I can't say as formatting, because formatting means you need to create a partition, whereas I need to remove all the partitions, and then I can make the disk ready for my NAS drive. So that's what I'm going to do. And I got this multi-bit screwdriver set so that I can open my laptop, and then I can also open this prototype device, and then I can pull out its mSATA drive. So let's just open the laptop, guys. So guys, I'm just done with removing the back cover and the battery over here. And here it has got this factory installed 1TB drive, and you can see it's just connected with this flex cable, and then there is a small provision for mSATA drive, which you can almost see here, and you can fix it with the screw. And this has been held together with this silicone bumper, as you can see, which you can pull it out, this tab. And once you pull, there is a small flat flex cable over here, which I can just pull it apart. I am sitting in a sort of awkward position so that I can get focus with the camera, so that I can just try to cover, because I can't mount a camera on my workbench or something as such. So I'm just trying as much as possible to capture the moments in the camera, so that you can easily see what I'm trying to do over here. So as you can see, this is the laptop's hard drive. This is a Toshiba drive, and it's a 1 TB. And what I what they have done is they have secured it with this silicone bumper, so that it withstands any sort of vibration. It's just a nice, amazing design, and it doesn't have any screws. You can just pull its tabs. There are small metal clips actually over here. It's an interesting design, so I just thought that is the reason of even shooting this video. I just want to show this as well as my NAS drives aspect. So you can just pull this apart. So here goes my hard drive. So let me just keep it aside. So you can see here, this is a small mount for 2.5-inch drive. It doesn't have any screws. Instead, it has small tabs over here. So in that case, what I'm going to do is, I need to fix this temporarily to this 128 GB drive till the time I start again using my PC, as I discussed before. So let me see where it exactly matches the tab. Yeah, so it exactly fits these small steel clips. It exactly fits into these mounting screw holes. So I can just put this way and little bit stretch this. Yeah, it's done. So as you can see here, I just able to fix this. So first thing what I'm going to do is, I will try to push this inside my laptop's hard drive bay, so that it properly securely fits inside that. So once again, let me connect this cable to this. Yeah, it's done. As you can see, it is fixed. And let me just show that to the camera, and I can just push it inside. Yeah, that's it, guys. So yeah, so So as you can see, it's a nice design. I never seen such a way any laptop's hard drive is mounted. So hopefully you can understand. This is not so important for SSD drives because they don't have any issues with the vibration or any sort of shocks or issues like that. Whereas it's quite important for traditional hard disk drives. So I just able to fit the same. Let me just check if it is done proper. Yeah, it's done. So next, what I need to do is I need to open this and I need to pull out its mSATA drive. So let me just do the same fast. So I just removed all the screws holding this back cover. So let me just open this. So this is the board, guys. It's quite interesting, as you can see here. I'm extremely happy that I purchased this, and I almost keep this very safely. Once I do some kind of prototyping or testing done, even these days, whenever I work on my TOFFEE project, I still continue to test on this device, and I do some benchmarking, and I do various experiments with this. The cool thing about it is it's very versatile, and its only drawback is unlike a laptop, it needs a dedicated monitor. But it's almost like you can imagine it's a giant version of Raspberry Pi without those GPIO pins. So this is it, guys. As you can see here, the most interesting aspect is it has two NIC cards with the label printer. I just printed as LAN and WAN ports, so you can see here, and it has all other interfaces which you can find it in any kind of PC. It is so versatile. You can make into a sort of video server, you can make all sorts of things with this kind of equipment as such. So it is very interesting. It's an Intel Celeron processor. It is not that powerful like an Intel NUC platform, but I just bought quite a long ago, even when Intel NUC started getting popular. So at that point of time, it's a nice piece of hardware, as you can see here. So what it has is it has this two boards. One is this wireless board which is connected over here, and wireless NIC card which is connected over here. The other board is the mSATA drive. So I need to remove this mSATA drive so that I can fit it in my laptop, and I can even in future I can even get a new SATA 2.5-inch laptop hard disk, and then I can fit it in this backplate as such. There are these provisions over here, as you can see here, mounting screw provisions are there. I can just fit it and I can connect this SATA cable to this. So what I want to do is I'm going to remove the same. Yeah, with this screw removed, it lifts this board up a little bit. So let me carefully keep aside the screw. So this is the mSATA drive. So this is from a manufacturer called as King Fast. This is not so great brand or something. I just purchased with this board as so. And the objective is also that I use this laptop as a sort of extension of my primary PC, so that if I am not available on my PC, I can use it as a alternate computing source, and I can also take it out if there is any client meeting or any sort of discussions with the customer or something. It will almost act as an extension. I can do almost everything what I do in the PC in this also. It will have similar applications installed, everything else. Only the case is I may not do any kernel development, and I may not do any sort of video editing. So 32 GB is more than enough, and I may not have any sort of virtual machines also. So and I'm not a guy who stores much audio and video content, so at the max, if I store, I may use another secondary hard drive, or temporarily I may use in this and I may delete it. So that's about it. So this is more than enough for my laptop, although it sounds very small. 32 GB is not so much sufficient for Windows world, whereas if you are using Ubuntu, this is a lot more enough, even for the latest Ubuntu release. So this is what. So let me keep this board aside, and let me just show this front of the camera. As you can see here, it exactly matches this bay over here, and there is that socket M SATA port, and I can just press this. I can just press this. Yeah, it fits exactly in that interface, and I need to connect. I need to screw that so that it stays in place securely. So let me just take the screw. So while doing all this, I'm making sure my feet is properly grounded. So make sure you are not doing on a carpet or something without anti-static wrap. So since I'm almost keeping my feet on the ground without any sandals or anything like that, it's almost it is little quite safer, so that there is no amount of statics which stays behind us. So and this is one issue I found quite often in my US stay in Arizona. Since the place is quite dry, you almost catch up static quite so often, and you touch anything, you get a shock. So I used to carry a dime, I used to carry a dollar or a cent always in my pocket, so that each time I touch any door handle or something, I just I try to ground it up, and then once it is grounded, and then I used to pull the door latches or even the car latches and car doors as such. So if not done, I used to get a shock, terrible shock each time. So yeah, I just securely connected the same, and even the hard disk is connected. So with this, the work on my laptop is done. I just keep it aside so that we can just immediately jump on or hop onto my NAS system. So before doing the same, what I need to do is I need to boot my laptop, and I need to disable the M SATA temporarily so that I can boot it directly on my SSD drive, and then I connect it to my NAS drive, because the SSD drive has my 2.5 inch SSD drive has everything installed, so I can start capturing the video inside the same, and I can connect to my NAS server, and I can show you the current disk installation status, and also I can show you the arrangement of my disks even before I try to pull it out. And at the same time, I also need to do is I need to connect this Toshiba hard drive, which is just now pulled out of this HP laptop, and I need to remove all the partitions so that I can connect to my NAS drive bay as well. So guys, I just connected everything, and then I screwed the backside cover of my laptop, and let me just boot the same. And I want to boot it in my 2.5 inch SSD drive. Yeah, it has just identified the drive configuration. Let me see which drive I can boot. Yeah, good that it is shows my 2.5 inch SSD drive, so that I can boot it from here. I'm booting in the same. So with this, I can make sure my everyday working system is up and ready as usual, the way I do, because either I use the SSD drive in this laptop, or sometimes I swap it to my system, and I don't use the PC quite frequently, because it is a sort of test system, and I may not use it quite frequently. I may use more my laptops once in a while, and once in a while I use it in my PC. So that's the thing. So since it is booted, what I can do is I can connect my NAS server, and I can boot my NAS server. I can just show it to the camera. Yeah, it is just started powering up. So let me just show a bit closer. So it is a 4 bay NAS which I got, and In this first bay, it has the 500 GB drive, which I'm supposed to replace with this 1 TB drive. So I don't want to skip this part because it's quite interesting. When I was about to buy my NAS system, I'm not finding proper videos on drive replacements, and also if there is sort of failure in any drive, how you can do the same. There are no much good YouTube videos. They always talk about reviews of various NAS systems, and they talk about how much storage it can have and stuff like that. But the main objective of buying any NAS is just in case if there is any drive failure or any sort of upgrade it you need to do, and in that case how you can do the same. So that's more important. So I thought that is the reason I thought shooting this video, in case if you are also confused or if you are also in a similar situation what I faced earlier. So it is just still booting. Let me just try. Once it is booted up, I can connect it to my system. Yeah, what I can do is I can hop over to my system, and parallelly I can do a video record. Let me just take a headphone. So let me just disconnect this camera feed, and we can just hop over to my system so that I can show exactly what I'm seeing in my desktop system. So just before I hop on to my desktop system, I just thought also this step. I got this hard disk drive enclosure. I opened it, and I can fit this hard drive into this so that I can, you know, mount it in my laptop, and I can remove all the partitions, and whatever I do in the laptop, anyway I'm capturing with the screen recorder, and whereas whatever you can see here in this physical stuff, you can I'm just trying to capture in this camera. So let me connect it to this enclosure. I don't want to fix something permanently. I just want to connect it and then just keep it aside, and once it is fully ready, I can connect with this cable, and then I can copy or I can delete entirely the drive contents of the same. So I have taken almost all the backups, so I don't need to worry anything about what exactly it contains as that inside. So it is I just fitted in this enclosure. What we can do is we can now hop on to my laptop, and I can just walk you across whatever I'm seeing in my laptop. So guys, I'm in my laptop, as you can see here, and you can see here my other mSATA drive, which is mounted as 30 GB volume. And sometime once I pull out this SATA drive, I can format this drive, and I can install freshly Ubuntu in this, and I can start using this as my primary drive for this laptop. So what I can do is I can connect to my NAS server and show you. So these are my various folders in my NAS server. So I am not interested in terms of reading anything in that. So instead, I can go to the GUI interface of ReadyNAS. So you can see here it has all these drives. It has this 500 GB drive, which is the drive which is I'm supposed to replace, as I discussed earlier. And apart from that, it has one 1 TB drive, 2 TB drive, and 3 TB drive. And I can show you I'm losing some amount of storage space because of this 500 GB drive. And since it has configured with X-RAID, you know, so it will lose some amount of storage space. And I believe once I replace this 500 GB drive with this 1 TB drive, I may get some amount of significant additional data storage space over here. So what I do is, let me connect this external drive. Yeah, as you can see here, it is having all these folders which are mounted. So what I can do is I can remove all these mounted partitions, and I can use a utility like disks. So let me reconnect so that it can appear over here. So as you can see guys, it has all these partitions. We can just unmount each partition. I can just click this square button. It indicates like stop. So with this I unmounted all the partitions, and I can go ahead and delete each partition. Since it is an extended partition, it has just almost wiped out the major area of the disk as well. So there are many partitions within the same. So let me also delete this partition. Delete this partition. So as you can see, the disk is fully free, and it is all the partitions are removed. So with this done, we can safely remove this drive. So it is fully unmounted. So with that I can remove the disk. What I can do is I can hop on to my camera, and I can start also show the steps I'm doing in terms of replacing my NAS drives. So guys, as you have seen, I'm just done with deleting all the partitions, and I'm going to disconnect this drive from this enclosure. And what I'm going to do is I'll just keep this hard drive aside, and what I'm going to do is I need to pull this 500 GB drive out of my NAS device. So just before doing the same, I want to record the screen capture, how it appears in my system asset. So let me just do a screen capture. So let me just pull the drive. So this is hot swap compatible, so I can just pull the drive when the device is powered on. I have just pulled the drive. Let me show it in my camera. So I have pulled this drive, and as you can see here, it shows the drive bay is empty, and it says also it is no more redundant, and it has degraded as well. So which means we are in trouble, and we are supposed to replace the drive as soon as possible, or replace with a new drive, or insert back the same drive into its respective slot. So with this we can understand, you know, it is the time is short, we need to do as soon as possible. So what I do is I hop onto my camera, and I can show you how I can connect my two small hard disk inside this huge 3.5 inch bay. So that's all guys. So I'm going to still wait some time so that it completes this process. It is doing the resyncing of the entire volume, and let me just show you my NAS LCD display. Now there is no panic, so there is no sort of blinking lights, and there is no blinking LCD display, but it shows the status as recover data, and 75.31% it is done. So this is the status it shows. So since it is not yet completed resyncing the process, or else rebuilding the RAID volume, so the size of the entire volume still remains the same. And I believe once it is fully reconstructed or rebuilt, its volume size is going to increase, and I may get some additional extra size by adding this 1 TB drive. And the increase in the size is going to be quite interesting because I have almost replaced the entire 500 GB drive, so it is going to give some additional 1 or 2 TB space or something like 1.5 TB of space, because I still have a 3 TB drive and a 2 TB drive in my NAS system. So totally the entire storage space is going to be around 6 TB, and with the X-RAID enabled in my ReadyNAS, I may get some overall say around 3 or 4 TB as such, I think so. So currently it has the current storage space is around 2.7 TB, and out of which 1.62 TB is allocated. So I believe once this is fully done, I may get additional space of around 1 to 1.5 TB of space. So that's all guys for this episode. So as I do with all my videos, this is not any training or this is not any sort of whiteboard session. I just want to casually show my work, and I want to share whatever I do once in a while in my home lab, and as a part of research, as a part of my other backend work, something like this. So I hope you guys liked watching this video. So you can also follow the similar steps just in case if you are also upgrading your NAS system. But please make sure you have gone through the manufacturer's documentation, because your specific NAS device model may change, and you may use Drobo or QNAP or Synology, and in that case you may need to follow some different kind of steps or some more extra steps. So make sure you have gone through that, and you can also do some similar steps so that you can play around with your NAS system just in case you need to upgrade and you need to extend its storage space, like in my case, and you need to reuse any of your unused hard drives lying around in your home. So I hope you guys liked watching this video guys. Thank you. In case if you have any questions, please post it across in YouTube comments. Thank you once again for watching this video. Have a nice day.